Hello everyone, in medical scribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. In the previous video, we talked about the sweaty glands in general, and we classified these glands into two main types, which are the eccrine sweaty gland and the apocrine sweaty gland. Then we explained the general structure of the sweaty gland. While today we will talk about the first type of these glands, which is the eccrine sweaty gland. The eccrine sweaty gland is the most common type of the sweaty glands, in which the human body has about 2 to 4 million of them. This type of glands will be found all over the body, especially on the thick skin of the palm of the hand and the soles of the feet. While we won't see this type of glands in the lips and in the external genitalia. Alright. These eccrine glands open directly on the skin surface, and they will extend from the skin surface till reaching the lower dermis. And every sweaty gland length about 3 to 5 mm and consists of two major parts, which are the secretory portion and the duct portion, which means it will consist of a portion that secretes sweat and a portion that carries the sweat to the outside. So firstly, we have the secretory portion. This portion composed of three types of cells, which are the clear cells, the dark cells, and surrounded by the myoepithelial cells. So, the clear cells will be responsible for the sweat secretion, while the dark cells, it's thought that these cells act as a repository for the bioactive materials that added to the sweat. Finally, the myoepithelial cells, which look like the smooth muscle in their contractility. These cells will give a structural support to the gland, and when contract, it will help in the secretion process. So all these details were about the secretory portion. While the duct portion, it will connect between the secretory portion and the skin surface. This duct also composed of two layers, which are the basal layer and the suprabasal layer, or the luminal layer. The main function of this duct is to transport the sweat to the skin surface from the secretory portion. And also, it's found that the duct will absorb the sodium and the chloride that exist in the sweat. And keep in your mind that the secretion process is regulated by sympathetic nervous system. Okay, now we have to explain the sweat that's secreted by these glands. The sweat that's secreted by the eccrine glands are clear, odorless sweat. It's composed mainly of water and electrolytes, such as sodium, chloride, bicarbonate, and potassium. And it's composed also of a little quantity from glucose, lactate, cytokines, and immunoglobulins. And they discovered that the sweat contained an antimicrobial peptide, which is the dermicidin. This sweat with all its contents will have three functions. Firstly, the thermal regulation. The sweat mainly regulates the body temperature. So when the internal body temperature rises, or when the person is feverish, or when the outside environment is hot, the eccrine glands will secrete sweat that contain water on the skin surface. And because of the high temperature, the water will evaporate. As a result, the body temperature will fall. The second function is the protection. This protection is done by two methods. The first one is that because the existence of the dermicidin, cathelicidin, and lactoferrin, which are an antimicrobial peptide, these materials will control the skin flora and fight the skin infections. While the second method, and as we say that because the sweat contains cytokines, such as the interleukin-1 and interleukin-31, and because of the immunoglobulin IgA, these immune components will provide an additional protection method. The third function, and finally, is that the sweat will consider as a moisturizing factor, that because of the lactate, urea, sodium, and potassium, they will preserve the skin hydration. And also, The sweat will mix with the sebum that is produced by the sebaceous gland that will make a moisturizing lipid layer that hydrates the skin also. So these were the general functions of the sweat that is produced by the eccrine glands. And we explained earlier almost everything about the eccrine sweat glands. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.